Report, Trump rejected 5 women sent to hotel room, we don't do that type of stuff, Bodyguard says. Who can bet that the MSM, the Democrats and the establishment are doing everything they can to take Trump and his administration down. Since they can't find a Trump-Russia collusion, they will keep digging up dirt, or as in Hillary Clinton's case, keep funding for more dossiers or fake news on Trump. So this news doesn't sit well with their narrative. Trump's longtime bodyguard and chief of security Keith Schiller was called before the House Intelligence Committee on Tuesday for a 4-hour, closed-door hearing, where he testified under oath about a number of issues, including the dossier, CNN reported. Schiller either denied or couldn't recall any of the accusations put forward in the dossier, despite repeated and repetitive questions from his congressional interlocutors. NBC News reported that Schiller explicitly denied one of the more salacious allegations in the dossier. It claimed Russian hookers were sent to Trump's hotel room during a trip to Moscow in 2013, where they were said to have engaged in certain activities that were caught on tape and held as blackmail by the Russians. In Moscow for the Miss Universe pageant, it was claimed that a Russian participant in the event informed Schiller that he would be sending 5 women to Trump's room for his entertainment, but Schiller testified that he rejected that offer. "We don't do that type of stuff," Schiller stated, according to 2 sources familiar with his testimony before the committee. Schiller recalled telling Trump about the offer later in the day and noted how they both laughed it off as ridiculous. He testified that Trump went to bed alone that evening with Schiller posted outside his room for a time before retiring for the night himself. Though he admitted that he didn't know if anything had occurred after he had left his post outside the room, he nevertheless testified under oath that he was confident nothing happened, certainly nothing involving Russian prostitutes. Schiller also made sure to note that Trump was always well aware that he could be under surveillance at any time, and made a habit of warning his associates to always be careful of what they said and did, particularly in a foreign country. It was also reported that Schiller testified to his reaction upon first seeing the Russian prostitute allegation put forward in the dossier, in which he claimed to have stated, "Oh my God, that's bullsh." It is worth noting that Schiller's rejection of the prostitutes is not a new story, but was first reported by the Daily Caller back in January, shortly after the dossier was first made public. At that time, an unnamed advisor to Trump was asked about the contents of the dossier, particularly about the Russian prostitutes. That advisor told the reporter that he knew for a fact that the supposed incident never occurred, and named Russian pop star Emin Alagreev as the individual who sent the women up to Trump's room. Emin was the son of Russian billionaire oligarch Aras Alagreev, who had partnered with Trump to host the 2013 Miss Universe pageant in Moscow. When Schiller received word of Emin's offer, he flatly rejected it and posted guards outside Trump's room to ensure nobody entered. Based upon Schiller's testimony, it would appear that he then took over for those guards at the end of the evening when Trump had gone to bed, alone. Once again, we see one of the anti-Trump media's narratives utterly blown out of the water. They have tried repeatedly to smear Trump as some sort of womanizing sexist, the sort who would take full advantage of Russian hookers sent to his hotel room. But unless Trump's most trusted associate and former chief of security just lied under oath to Congress, none of that ever happened, and wouldn't have happened, as we don't do that type of stuff. As we already know, Hillary Clinton would stop at nothing to destroy Trump or anyone else in her path to the presidency. She has way too much dirt to hide. She will continue to pull trash out of dumpster and throw it in the MSM to try to paint an image of Trump that doesn't exist. Even though she took in millions of donations from her dirtbag Hollywood sex abuser, Harvey Weinstein. Isn't it wild that most of the stories she tells about Trump turned out to be real stories about herself or the Clintons? When she accused Trump of a Russian collusion, it was really her that paid for the dossier from Russia. Fake news drummed up to destroy Trump. When she accused Trump of illegal dealings, it was really her that was involved in the Uranium One deal to Russia. When she accused others of sexual misbehavior. Well, we all know, don't we? Sooner or later the other shoe will drop.